first giving a short introduction and getting everyone on the same page what keto actually does. So in Ory Keto, as it is based on the sense bar paper, we have the so-called relation tuples, and they're the basic, let's say data structure. And there are two types of relation tuples that you can also see in this example. So you can have a relation tuple that describes a relation between an object and a subject, which sounds pretty generic and also is pretty generic because objects, relations, and subjects are just strings. And it's up to you how you interpret them. Keto will just give you all the connections between those relations. So the second type of relation tuples that we can have is the ones with subject sets. They basically, that's the second example here. So the second example would basically mean that everyone who has access to object zero, so this part is the subject set. So everyone who has access to object zero also has object two, access to object one. And this is a way to indirect and define relations based on other relations. And all of this is then used to define permissions. So for example, you can say that if you have this relation or if you have that relation, you actually have access. And those can be combined in various ways. And what actually is the basic idea behind all of this is that the, these relations result in a graph of relations, where this graph is just a very standard directed graph. And we can apply standard graph algorithms to this graph, and in such a case, or such an algorithm would be to actually do a permission check, boils down to having a reachability problem on the graph. So if an object is reachable through a specific relation from a subject, it's considered that this is a true request. So the check API will basically allow the request to go through. And if there is no connection, then it will say false. And that's the very basic idea behind all of this. And we can then also build trees of how the relations work out when you start to resolve them and all of these interactions. So you can do audits on basically this graph structure. So that's the very basic idea behind the sense bar paper, or the graph-based permissions. We have here set up a very basic Node.js server. So what we have here is just very basic server. It's actually running in the background. Here you can just see we listen on a port, set some course headers, and here handle get and post. What this is basically just a very simple cloud storage. So acts like a key value store, but key is the file name, value is the file content. And we can also now, in this presentation, we have a built-in client. So we can launch the client as well. And just ignore the username field for a good time. We'll come to that later, but let's just say we want to put, let's say example.txt file content, just something. And then we use post, just a REST post API. This is very hacked together, so don't judge by the bad user interface, but at least it works. The basic idea here is we just have a get which reads a file and serves it if it is possible. So tries to read a file and serve it, just returns an error if it can't find it, can't open it for whatever reason. And the post is just the opposite of that. It writes the file. So very simply here, we just read the body and write the file. And now that we want to add the first thing you might or should or would probably want to add, let's say it's just a requirement set by whatever metric or whatever stakeholders we have here. So we want to track ownership of files, and we want to then later add permissions so only owners can read, can modify, can update a file, and can change the sharing permissions and all of that stuff. So for that, what we do is we add here, I have a small div to show you, so you can easily follow what was added. And what we add here is just some imports here. And this is basically just a small helper function here. Small disclaimer, this gRPC client that we use here in this example is auto-generated, and therefore the code is not super nice to read, but at least it's better than doing everything by hand. So that's also a thing that we would like to improve going on, to have some nicer SDKs and stuff, but this just works for the time. So basically all that we have here is the helper function that creates keto permissions down to here basically. And what we do is we create a relation tuple. What I have spared you from in the short introduction before is namespaces. It's basically just a way to organize objects, so you cannot have or you can distinguish objects that might have the same ID, although they should never have the same ID. But it's just a way to organize stuff, and later also will be to configure some effects of relations. So for example, you could have a relation that basically excludes someone from a relation instead of adding. So all of that is configurable through the namespaces. But all you have to know now is that we use the files namespaces for the example. And we set the path of the file as the object and have an owner relationship and as the subject. So if you follow here, that's namespace object relation. And here as the subject, we set the username. And then we just basically do an API call to Ory Keto to store this relation. Right, and then that's the helper function that we have. And then here is actually how we integrate it into the post handler. We have here a very hacky way, but it is basically for this example, it serves the purpose. So we have the authorization header contains the username. Obviously, in a real world application, you would use, for example, JWTs that are set or that are created, or you might buy an upstream service, or you might want to use, you could use, for example, Ory Authkeeper to do that. But basically what we do here is we get the user information, and then we just add the ownership relation between the file and the username. That's just this helper function here. But yeah, the basic idea here is that whenever we create a file, we just track this relation in Ory Keto, and then later we can request whether a relation exists for permission checks. So that's what we do here. We have added here also a lot of imports and a small helper function that allows us to do a check whether a user is an owner of a file. It's basically just the reverse of what we did. It's just looking up whether in the namespace files, the user that we have is the owner of the file. So user here, file here. So we just do a check with keto to see whether that's the case. Here we also same thing, extract a username from authorization. And then what we do is we check whether the user is owner of the file. And in case the user is not, we just reply with an error. And in case the user is, we serve the file. So nothing changed here. And now we can also see this in action. Now the username comes in handy. So let's say I want to add a file. So my username is Patrick. I want to add this file and I want to add some content. So don't show anyone else. And when I post this, we get a success result. And now we can do a check to get this file as well. So same username, me, and I want to get that's a small bug in the presentation because I have a keyboard event on when pressing C, but it's not fixed to type C. So that's what you just saw. So we get this, we see the content that we just posted. And if we try this the same with some different username, we should hopefully see you're not allowed to read the file. So that's exactly this check here. So this failed, and because of that, we got the message, you're not allowed, you're not the owner of the file. Now, one problem is that we now check directly for ownership. You might want to, for example, share the file with someone else and you're the owner of the file, so you're allowed to share it. Someone else might read it, but they might not update it, or they might not be able to share it further, but they might be able to update it. So all of this somehow has to be reflected, and it's not solely reflected by the ownership relation. And we basically, with this case, limit ourselves and limit our flexibility to actually implement permissions on top of this ownership relation. So instead, what we should do is track the relations as they are, but then actually define the permissions based on the relations. So what we do is, instead of checking whether someone is an owner, we check for the read relation. This is a new relation that we just introduced. And the read relation is defined, can be defined in a lot of different ways. So one would, of course, be just having, being owner implies automatically that you can also read. But one other might be that you get a shared link that when you're in possession of that link, you are allowed to read the file, and you still are not the owner of the file and you might not be able to edit it. That's why this abstraction is important. And so, of course, we have to add a bit more code or change a bit more code. This is just a renaming of the function here and also adjusting the error output so it's more accurate describing what's happening. But now we create a second tuple. And you might notice that this is called workaround tuple. And that's for a specific reason, because that's how you currently have to implement that in keto, but it's considered a workaround because we would have at some point subject set rewrites that also Ashley talked about in the previous talk, and they will allow you to do this without actually adding tuples. So they would allow you to define that everyone who's owner also has read access without actually doing that. But as we don't have that yet, the workaround is that we define another tuple, and that other tuple is here. It just says that you can read the file. And here comes now the subject set into play. If you are owner of the file. So notice that here in this workaround tuple, the username itself does not appear, but we define read through ownership. So this gives us flexibility later on. So we will be able to later remove that permission. We can later, adjust that. And here the diff is just a bit messy. Sorry for that. But basically, it's just adding both tuples instead of just one. It might define that, for example, if you have write, you also have read. That's also very common to have with a permission. I would now like to ask you for some next steps that you should take. So this presentation will be uploaded to GitHub once I fix some issues that I've just hot patched right now. It will be available. And if you just run npm I, npm start, you will get all the servers, you will get Keto running in the background, you will get the example server running. You can go through the presentation, you can just check out all the steps and all the code that is there. And you can also use the built-in client in the presentation. You just have to press C and it pops up, so this one. So thank you very much for tuning in, and hope to see you on GitHub later.